Howdy, I'm Derek, and today I want to show you a couple of powerful Excel formula functions that you probably have never used, scan and map. These are two of the dynamic array functions, commonly known as DAFs, that can work with and output arrays of results rather than just calculate one cell value at a time. If you haven't used DAFs much, you are really missing out. They provide some incredible benefits. Here are four of them. First, they simplify complex formulas by bringing everything together, eliminating the need for helper functions and nested if statements that can make things hairy very quickly. Second, the size of the cell output range, called spilling, can automatically change based on changes to your source data. So it can either expand below to the right or both based on how you've configured it. Third, they usually calculate more quickly because you've got that one spilling formula instead of a whole bunch of formulas across your cells. And similarly, number four, they help you reduce errors by bringing it all together in that one formula versus all over the place where you might have forgotten to expand it or make a change. Whether you use DAFs like this by themselves or you combine them all together to make some really cool stuff, what you can do with them is pretty wild. In the comments below, check out the link to the wildest DAF-driven formula that I've ever made if you want to see what complex can look like. So first of all, let's walk through the scan function. In this example, we've got a column full of dates, which is driven by a DAF, and then we've got a daily amount, again, just using sequence right here, and then we've got the scan function, and we'll come back to that. So notice that if we change the input that they're all linked to, 365 days, to 5, everything updates automatically. Okay, we can make it 15, we can make it back to 365. Okay, updates automatically. Oop, wrong cell there. Okay, now, when we look at the scan function itself, what this is really doing is saying, hey, here's one, okay, accumulate one, then we want to add two to one, so three, add three to make it six, etc. So this is based on this push-up challenge I've been doing. So on January 1st, I do one push-up. End of the year, we're doing 365. I'm not necessarily looking forward to that, but I'm willing to stick with it. Doing pretty well a couple months into the year. Now, what scan is doing here? We're providing it three parameters. The first thing is the initial value, which could be hard-coded or it could be linked to a cell. Generally, that's zero, but it doesn't have to be. Second parameter is an array. Now, instead of saying B16 through 380 or whatever that is, okay, you can use the hashtag shortcut to say, hey, give me the entire array that starts in B16. Really cool shortcut. I highly recommend you try that out. And then our third parameter is an anonymous lambda function. This could be a named function if you want it to be. In our case, we're just using anonymous. And what we're saying is here's A is our aggregator, B is part of that array that we've supplied there in column B, and then our function or our calculation is just A plus B. So scan remembers the values from before. It aggregates, okay? So this is a very simple calculation here. We're just adding them together, and then the result you get is that 66,795, okay? Now, it's really just like adding all these up. So you could use a sum function. There are ways to do this, but dynamically, there you go, that's the best way. If you only want the end result, notice that the reduce function takes the exact same parameters and it only gives you that last value. Now here it doesn't really make sense. You could just use sum, but if you're doing a more advanced calculation, you know, reduce would really help you just take the ending result of all that without that dynamic array of all the values. So that scan, really helpful when you need to do a calculation like that. Map is kind of similar, okay? But instead of remembering other results, it allows you to apply a calculation to all of the items within one or more arrays you're supplying. So in this sample data that we have here, there's a bunch of fun names I like to use in examples, and a name and then a food that goes along with it. And we have a letter we're gonna find, which is case sensitive. And then within the map function, let's see what we're doing here, okay? We have a bunch of values in column A, and that's what we want to look through. Column B is the text we want to look for within those. And in our lambda function here is, you know, we're supplying A and B, which are those two arrays, which in this case, to keep it simple, map to A and B, the columns. And then we have a function here. So we're using if-air and wrapping that around a find function. We're looking for B within A. If we don't find it, return a zero. So it's looking for the position of a case-sensitive letter. Okay, again, this can be a named lambda instead of an anonymous function. It's up to you. And you can have several arrays here. You're only required to have one, but you could have 10 of them if you want. I believe it's hundreds if you really wanted to use a whole bunch of them. I've never used more than like five in practice. But again, this can be a really complicated function if you wanted it to be. I used this the other day in an agenda that I made where we're comparing the start time and the end time and kind of adding it up and leaving blanks and things. And map was great because as we were tweaking it, we were inserting rows and deleting rows, dynamically was updating. Kind of like here, if we were to delete a bunch of these rows right here, it's gonna automatically just calculate. You know, it doesn't really care, okay? Because it's a dynamic function, you don't have to fill or delete the rows. Don't have all those ref errors, okay? So pretty slick way to dynamically make sure you address all the different cells and you apply whatever function that you want to, okay? If you find yourself using the same formulas like these, consider building them into a custom lambda function to reuse them very quickly and then have a library of all those so you can apply them and add them to any workbook very, very quickly. This saves you time and allows you to manage them from one place and share from the people that you work with to save them time as well. Make sure to download this example file in the article that accompanies this video with a link in the comments. And if you want to learn about how all the other DAFs work, check out the DAF workbook in the comments below that has tips, gotchas, and examples for all of those different functions. And then lastly, check out the XLEV8 Excel add-in. It has hundreds of custom Excel tools that help you save 200 plus hours a year with common Excel tasks, including working with formulas like this. Just go to the apps section at www.xlev8.co or use the link in the comments below. If you enjoyed this, please like, comment, share, and tag with friends, and subscribe so you don't miss out on other cool tools, tips, and tricks. Thanks for watching and have an excellent rest of your day.